I got a really fun story to share today. I was checking the answering machine at the church, and I got a message, an anonymous message that said, "Hey, I noticed I was at Cumberland Farms, and I noticed that the baby Jesus from your nativity was missing." So I'm like, "Huh, that's interesting." And I thought that's kind of weird. And sure enough, the nativity that we have out in front of our church with baby Jesus was indeed missing. And so the message went on to say that this person noticed that up at Woodlawn Apartments at the bus stop, there was a baby Jesus. So I drove up to Woodlawn Apartments just to check it out for myself. And sure enough, there in the bus stop was baby Jesus. And this was indeed the baby Jesus that came from our nativity scene. So I grabbed baby Jesus and brought baby Jesus back down to our nativity scene and put him back in place. And then actually today, the whole nativity got put away for the season. But I thought it was the strangest situation. First of all, baby Jesus was missing from our nativity. Now, many of you know that I love nativities. I think they're really cool. I think they're a great way to celebrate Christmas. And so baby Jesus was missing out of our nativity. Somebody noticed the other one out of place at Woodlawn Apartments, told us about it. We were able to get Jesus, bring Jesus back. Kind of a funny story. But as I was thinking about it, I'm like, you know, how long was Jesus missing? I just started to wonder, like, how long was Jesus missing? Like, I don't know when Jesus disappeared, and I don't know how long he was gone. So, you know, I thought to myself, you know, wow, isn't that so true? I mean, there's so many churches that Jesus isn't at the center of everything that they do. He isn't at the center of their beliefs. They just want to believe what culture thinks or what seems right to them. And then they stop really following what the Word of God says. People stop going to church. They fall out of it because of this or that or the next thing. And maybe they're even showing up, but then all of a sudden they stop believing, you know, what the Word says. And I thought of this passage from the book of Psalms, chapter 103, which says, "Praise the Lord, O my soul. All my inmost being, praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits." And forget not all of his benefits. And so in this idea of how long was Jesus missing, I thought I would challenge you with this question today. How long has it been since you talked to Jesus? How long has it been since you prayed? Sometimes we can think that everything is good, but all of a sudden we'll realize I haven't prayed in a long time. Praying is the place that we execute faith and where we say, "God, I believe in you and I'm asking you for help." Next question. When is the last time you heard from Jesus? The primary way we hear from Jesus is reading the Bible. When's the last time you read the Bible so that you had heard, you heard God talk to you through his word? Sometimes unintentionally, the Bible could be missing from our life for days, maybe weeks, and maybe for you, maybe it's years. Maybe you haven't read your Bible in years, or maybe it's a decade or decades since you've read the Bible. I want to challenge you, don't let Jesus go missing from your life. When's the last time you've been to church? When's the last time you showed up at church? Maybe it was just, you let a week slip or 2 weeks slip. Maybe you let 3 weeks and a month, and maybe then 2 or 3 months, or maybe you haven't been to church in a year or two, or maybe it's been a decade since you've been to church. Don't leave baby Jesus. Don't leave Jesus out of your life. Don't let him go missing. Make sure that prayer, make sure that the word, make sure that fellowship with the church and believers is a part of your life. When's the last time, you know, you just saw Jesus up close? When's the last time you saw him up close? It wasn't just something that was a distant thing that you're remembering from back when you were a kid. or when you were a teenager, or even when you were a younger adult. But it's something that you remember from today, because this is the reality of your relationship and your faith, is that I spend time with Jesus. And so, you know, it's kind of a cliche saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. The old saying goes, if Jesus feels far away, guess who moved? That's right. It wasn't Jesus who moved. If Jesus feels far away, it was us that moved. In this case, Jesus from our nativity was missing. But in our real life, if Jesus is missing, it's not because Jesus is missing. It's because we went rogue. We stopped praying. We stopped reading. We stopped fellowshipping with the church. We stopped believing. We stopped executing faith. We stopped growing in Him. We stopped living in such a way as to make sure that we were having fellowship with God and living for Him and for His purposes. So I want to challenge you today. Funny little story that Jesus in our nativity disappeared. We got Him back. Funny joke, whatever. He's back. I don't care. But what I do care about is this. I care that you don't let Jesus slip away. I care that He's a part of your life and that He's changing every part of you, that you're not just believing as the world believes, but that you're in the Word, you're letting Him transform you, you're having fellowship with Him, and you're living the purpose-filled life that He desires for you to live. So forget not the Lord. Don't forget His benefits. Don't forget His salvation. Don't forget the hope that He came to bring you. Get close to Him. If He got far away, guess who moved? It's time for you to move back. God bless you and keep growing.